Welcome to Jung Tuition. I am Jung. This is my Christmas gift from my children. Do I look like Tintin today? Let me know in your comments. Let's continue discussing basic issues in climate research over the past 160 years. Unlike other YouTube channels, you will be delighted or sometimes surprised to find first-hand information and new discoveries about climate research, rather than some superficial comments or second-hand bias propaganda. How do universities train future climate researchers nowadays, you may wonder? Well, they teach them how to prove global warming due to CO2 by using some simple climate model in the first place. This is one of such models for teaching purpose I found from the website of Department of Meteorology and Atmospheric Science, Pennsylvania College of the Earth and Mineral Sciences. It is a rather simple model in which the atmosphere is treated as a single layer above the ground, which has been used for many years. But this model is wrong, terribly wrong. I'm going to tell you why. So, are you ready? I mean to like, share, subscribe. Of course, you can do it after watching this short talk. Okay, let's go and have fun. This is the diagram they used to describe their climate model, in which TS and TA are the temperatures for the surface and the atmosphere, respectively. Here, it is assumed that the atmosphere is transparent to solar radiation, meaning no shortwave radiation can be absorbed by their model atmosphere. As a result, the energy for infrared radiation by the atmosphere is merely provided by the heated surface. Remember this. Like all climate models based on the greenhouse effect hypothesis, it is also assumed that the atmosphere layers with water vapor and CO2 can radiate infrared ray both upward and downward. The downward one is often called the back radiation, as I discussed several times. Using epsilon to denote the emissivity of the atmosphere layer, which also denotes the absorptivity, according to Kirchhoff's law, the following equation is introduced. 2 epsilon sigma T to the power of 4 equal to epsilon sigma multiply TS to the power of 4. Where sigma is Stefan Boltzmann constant. Notice the factor 2 suggests that the layer of their model atmosphere can radiate in 2 vertical directions, downward to the surface and upward to the space. Both are powered by its absorption from the surface, namely sigma TS to the power of 4. By deleting epsilon and sigma in this equation, it is easy to obtain this dependence of the atmospheric temperature TA on the surface temperature TS. Or by removing the fourth root, we got a TS equal to 1.19 multiply T sub A, which means the surface temperature is always 1.19 times warmer than the atmosphere, in respective of how much infrared ray can be emitted or absorbed, because this equation is independent of the atmospheric emissivity. Sounds reasonable, but very strange. although one of my regular viewers seems to dream of such temperature difference. Am I right? Given the surface temperature 288 Kelvin, the temperature of their atmosphere should be 242.2 Kelvin. What does that mean? Because the upward radiation is epsilon multiplied sigma multiply T sub A to the power of 4, and the transmitted surface radiation is given by bracket 1 minus epsilon and multiply sigma and multiply T sub S to the power of 4, whose sum must equal to the outgoing radiation, 240 watt per meter square. That is a radiative balance condition at the top of atmosphere. From this equation, one can obtain the emissivity epsilon equal to 0.77. Meanwhile, the dependence of the surface temperature on the emissivity can be derived as follows. Notice that this graph shows how the surface temperature increases from 255 Kelvin to 303 Kelvin as emissivity epsilon, or the absorptivity of the model atmosphere, increases from 0 to 100%, at which the temperature of the model atmosphere is 255. Sounds reasonable? As a matter of fact, Arrhenius also derived a similar formula for his climate model with a single layer model atmosphere in 1896, as shown here. Can you see? The form of the formula is identical to the one we just derived. Although he first eliminated his atmospherical temperature by using the power balance condition at the surface. So, the climate issue has long since been settled. Oh, really? Let's return to that strange equation. It indicates the atmospherical radiation is merely powered by the heated surface by means of radiation. But Arrhenius knew this is untrue because both the shortwave radiation from the sun and the non-radiative mechanism can also supply the atmosphere with the energy to emit infrared ray, such as convection. That's why in Arrhenius' first paper on climate, published in 1896, the upward infrared radiation by the atmosphere was written as in this form. As you can see, additional two terms show up, where alpha is the shortwave absorptivity of his single layer atmosphere. A is the solar radiation at the top of the atmosphere, and M is the unknown non-radiative contribution. If we solve for the emissivity epsilon from this equation, we obtained this formula. What can you see? If one assumes the strange equation is valid, then the denominator in this equation would be zero. As a result, the emissivity would be infinity, as you can see in this deep abyss, this 3D diagram. In essence, it implies the predicted global warming by CO2 is based on the divergence, similar to quantum field dynamics. In other words, the strange equation here shows no beautiful universality, but an ugly singularity. Why is it so? Because it is just a fantasy to imagine any layer in the model atmosphere could be act as a double-sided black body that emits twice as much predicted by Stefan Boltzmann law. This silly assumption is equivalent to that you have to pay everyone around you when you buy something in a shop, not just the cashier. Do you know what I mean? I hope you could understand now what is terrible wrong in those singular climate models, widely used to train future climate researchers. If you or your child is studying climate in Pennsylvania State College of Earth and Mineral Sciences, please ask their head to delete this disgraceful teaching material. Many similar climate models for teaching purpose can be found at the websites of the University of British Columbia, University of Albany, Wikipedia, Colorado State University, Monash University, to name but a few. If you can find more, please add them here as a comment. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your donation. See you next time.